With me on the line this morning from Power Metal Resources, I'm joined by Paul Johnson. Paul, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
An update on Kalahari Key this week. The ground geophysics, that program's been complete. Paul, tell us a bit more.
Yes, no problem. Well, we're punching out updates thick and fast at the moment across the business, and on this one we are particularly excited. It's Botswana. Obviously, I have a little bit of history in Botswana and some success in the past, so we're delighted that they're moving forward at pace. Now, Power Metal Resources has an 18.26% shareholding in Kalahari Key, which is a holding company in Botswana, for the Molopo Farms Complex project. It's a single project business. And we have a right to earn into 40% direct project interest. should we choose to do so, we can elect to earn in by the end of 2019, and we have to spend $500,000 on the project by the end of 2020. Now, they're moving through a staged exploration process. So they did helicopter airborne electromagnetic work. They identified 17 targets that they wanted to look into in a bit more detail. They moved to the ground and they did ground geophysics, and that's completed now. The program that they planned out completed earlier on this month, and we announced that on the 13th of August, and we're delighted that they're moving forward in a very disciplined, organized fashion. Botswana is under sand cover. There's not surface expression of the mineralization, so they have to use these new technologies to find potential ore bodies below the surface. The information that's feeding out all the way through has been increasingly positive. We're really pleased with the team there, and they're making great progress.
So some of this data from the program just complete, that's in the process of being interpreted with the idea of drill testing in the near term some of these key targets, is that right?
That's right, yes. So from from the helicopter work, they identified 17 targets. The groundwork has focused on 10 of the best target areas, and they've taken 11 loops over those 10 best target areas. What they're looking for is the 1, 2, 3, or 4 key targets to drill. And ultimately, in this type of territory, unless you sink the holes and get the data from below the surface with the drill core and so on, then you don't know. So what we hope is that over the rest of this month, they will undertake the interpretation of this immense amount of data. They'll sit down and work out exactly which of the targets they want to drill and why. They'll present a detailed report to us, we hope that that report is compelling and enables us then to move to the next stage, which is to say, yep, we would like to earn into 40% direct project interest. If we do that, we have an effective interest of 51% in this project, which is a great percentage for us. Back in the Metal Tiger days, Metal Tiger had a 30% direct project interest, so it's a bit higher than that. But the excitement level is comparable to back in the day with Metal Tiger when we were looking at the Botswana project in conjunction with MOD Resources. For us at Power Metal Resources, it's exactly the same kind of feeling. Very pregnant with excitement, pregnant with news flow from this project, and we're looking forward to see what they come back with in their report.
And as you say, punching out these updates thick and fast, this program, just one of four active operations you've got on the go. Do you feel the market's starting to get their heads around the strategy and what Power Metal Resources is all about?
Oh, no. I don't think so at all, no. And that's understandable because sentiment is extremely low. People are very reticent, don't want to engage with new ideas, new things too easily. They want to have the case proven to them beyond all reasonable doubt, and that's my job. I have to go out and evangelize and tell people about what we're doing. We have four countries of operation where we're active at the moment. We've got four main projects. Each of them has considerable potential to deliver a company transformational discovery for our business. Whether you're looking at the DRC with a near 7 kilometer copper anomaly, you're looking at Cameroon with our projects next door to the Kamuna large cobalt deposits, whether you're looking at Botswana with this tremendous opportunity looking for nickel copper PGMs, very, very elephant scale size targets, or whether you're looking at the JV that we have with Katoro Gold over the Hennetti Nickel Project. Each one of these is a potential mineral monster, and we are looking hard and fast at each of them, and we're doing work in each of these different four jurisdictions to try and find that first major discovery. We'd like to find more than one discovery. But it's important for me to keep going out and telling this message time and again and demonstrating to people that just as with other companies where I've been involved, we are working hard, we'll deliver the news to market on a regular basis, and little by little, we will start to win people over, I'm sure, and then we'll get that little tidal wave build up to a big gush where people show interest, start to engage with the stock, start to read the RNS in a bit more detail, perhaps buy a few shares, and we don't need an awful lot of buying in this thin market to have a major impact on the stock price. So we'll push ahead and we'll keep going, but by far and away, we are not yet on radar, and we need to be.
Well, we'll have to get you back in the studio soon, Paul, for a more detailed discussion.
Oh, that would be lovely, and I imagine that won't be too far away because we do need to come back to market and give a full update on across all of our activities.
Many thanks, Paul. Thanks for the update.
Thank you.